नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, आर एंड टैरो में आपका स्वागत है। शॉर्ट्स जब भी हमारी रीडिंग में आते हैं वो इशारा करते हैं माइंड की तरफ, इंटेलेक्ट की तरफ, थॉट्स की तरफ। जो सबसे ज़्यादा जो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड जो कार्ड्स जो आपको पूरे सूट्स में दिखेंगे टैरो कार्ड में, वो हैं शॉर्ट्स के कार्ड। और क्योंकि वो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हैं तो वो इंटरेस्टिंग भी बहुत है। बाकी के सूट्स के जो रीडिंग है अगर आप देखेंगे तो इट्स एक्चुअली मच सिंपलर एज़ कम्पेयर टू शॉर्ट्स। तो मेरे देखे शॉर्ट्स जितने इंटरेस्टिंग हैं उतने कॉम्प्लिकेटेड भी हैं। शॉर्ट्स आज जो हम बात करने वाले हैं जिस कार्ड की, वो है टू ऑफ शॉर्ट्स। और जब भी हम टू की बात करते हैं, टू जो है सिग्निफाई करता है रिलेशनशिप के लिए, पार्टनरशिप के लिए, कम्युनिकेशन के लिए, अ काइंड ऑफ अ डील विच इज़ हैपनिंग बिटवीन टू पीपल हु आर कमिंग टुगेदर। सो दिस इज़ व्हाट द टू विच इज़ मोस्टली सिग्निफाइंग। इट्स ऑल्सो सिग्निफाइंग द बैलेंस ऑफ यिन एंड यांग, द फोर्सेज ऑफ अपोजिट, यू नो, ब्लैक एंड वाइट। सो टू अपोजिट फोर्सेज कमिंग टुगेदर, दैट इज़ व्हाट टू सिग्निफाई हियर। तो टू ऑफ शॉर्ट्स की रीडिंग में जाने से पहले इसके कीवर्ड्स जानेंगे। इसके कीवर्ड्स हैं डिफिकल्ट डिसीजन, वेइंग अप ऑप्शंस, अवॉइडेंस, इनडिसीजन, कंफ्यूजन, स्टक, नॉट एबल टू मेक अप द माइंड, ब्लाइंड फोल्डेड। सो अगर हम इसके पिक्चोरियल में जाएंगे, पिक्चोरियल में हम देखते हैं कि एक फिगर, प्रॉब्ली अ फीमेल फिगर, इज लाइक सिटिंग ऑन द बेंच विथ टू शॉर्ट्स क्रॉस लाइक दैट। पीछे का हम एनवायरनमेंट देखते हैं, दैट इज अ लाइक अ सी और अ ओशन बिहाइंड। एंड उसके जो है बैकग्राउंड में हम देखते हैं देयर इज अ वैक्सिंग मून, अ क्रिसेंट मून विच इज देयर। सो जो जनरल रीडिंग है इस कार्ड की, जनरल रीडिंग जो है वो, जो कि हम सबको ही एक्चुअली में सबको पता है, जनरल रीडिंग ये है कि अ काइंड ऑफ अ सिचुएशन इन विच वी आर नॉट रेडी टू ओपन आर आईज एंड फेस इट। सो इट्स अ सिचुएशन विच इज शोन लाइक यू आर स्टक समवेयर एंड यू आर नॉट एबल टू मूव एंड यू आर नॉट एबल टू टेक अ डिसीजन एंड यू आर सो स्टक दैट यू आर ऑल्सो नॉट एबल टू सी द रियलिटी ऑफ इट। इसके बहुत टेक्स हैं इस कार्ड के, मैं कुछ टेक्स की इसमें बात करूँगा। जो फर्स्ट टेक है जो मुझे जो दिखता है वो ये कि लाइक दिस पर्सन और लाइक यू आर इन सम काइंड ऑफ अ पोजिशन इन दिस टैरो कार्ड वे यू कांट मूव, वे यू आर स्टक एंड इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ एन ऑटो पायलट विच इज़ हैपनिंग टू यू। नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू व्हाई आई सेड ऑटो पायलट। जो सूट्स हैं, देर आर फोर सूट्स, वॉन्ड्स, पेंटिकल्स, शॉर्ट्स एंड कप्स। इसमें से दो जो हैं सूट्स जो हैं मैस्कुलिन प्रिंसिपल के हैं और दो जो हैं फेमिनिन प्रिंसिपल के हैं। जो शॉर्ट्स हैं और वॉन्ड्स हैं वो मैस्कुलिन प्रिंसिपल है एंड जो पेंटिकल्स हैं और जो कप्स हैं वो फीमेल प्रिंसिपल हैं। They are more feminine. अब इस कार्ड में because it's a sword card and there is a woman which is shown in the card, so somewhere it's a kind of an unbalance which is shown. So it's like shows a position of someone who is like feminine at heart and who is not able to actually balance with the masculine side which is the sword. तो अगर हम इनकी बात करें, ये जो हम पिक्चर में देखते हैं, दिस इज़ अ पर्सन हु जो हैं वो, उनका फेमिनिन नेचर है बहुत, और फेमिनिन नेचर होने की वजह से जो मैस्कुलिन जो उनका जो माइंड है उसके साथ वो बैलेंस नहीं हो पा रहा। इसलिए एक देर इज़ अ पोजिशन विच शी स्टक, शी इज़ नॉट एबल टू यूज़ द इंटेलेक्ट और द हार्ट प्रॉपरली and this is a decision where she has to use her intellect because it's a sword card. So you are in a position where you have to take a decision out of your intellect बट नो डिसीजन कैन नॉट बी कम्प्लीट विदाउट द हार्ट इन्वॉल्व, विदाउट द इमोशंस इन्वॉल्व. सो सबसे पहली चीज जो हम देखते हैं वो ये कि दैट देर इज एन अनबैलेंस विच इज हैपनिंग बिटवीन द माइंड एंड द हार्ट, बिटवीन द इंटेलेक्ट एंड द इमोशंस. तो जब हम ऑटो पायलट की बात कर रहे हैं तो देर इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ पैटर्न विद विच वी लिव आर लाइफ, यू नो. एंड दिस ऑटो पायलट कम्स इन टू आर लाइफ वेन विच विथ ओनली इट इट कम्स इन टू आर लाइफ वेन वी आर नॉट रियली एबल टू वर्क विथ टोटल फैकल्टीज विच आर गिवन टू अस. जो माइंड एंड हार्ट की जो फैकल्टी जो आपको दी हुई है, अगर आप इन दोनों को इकट्ठा नहीं यूज करेंगे देन देर विल बी अनबैलेंस ऑलवेज. देन यू विल गो इन टू अनकॉन्शियस डिसीजन्स. Then you will start operating in an autopilot way. That's what the card is actually trying to tell us, is that you are operating in an unconscious way right now. And the only way of doing it is, like if this person has a balance of heart and emotion, then the swords will balance it out and this person will be able to take the right decision and the blindfold will come off. This is what mostly the two of swords is telling us. So as I said that this is the card of a kind of a fight between your heart and mind, your intellect and emotion. The fight will keep on will continue unless and until you come to a balance. तो इस unbalance की वजह से एक ऐसी position भी show करती है कि there is a kind of a rut, there is a kind of a, you know, repeat pattern which is happening. That there is a fight which is happening inside of you. For example, you are going on a trip. आप किसी trip में जा रहे हैं और trip में जाते हुए जो है आपने अपने घर का जो है दरवाज़ा, अब आपको doubt है कि आपने वो बंद करा या नहीं करा. अब you are on a flight and you started thinking about it. You started thinking whether I locked the door or not. And now what is going to happen is one part of you, one mind. One part of your mind will start saying, you know, like, yes, don't worry. We have locked it. I have locked the door myself, you know. I remember it. But after some time, there is another part which will say, no, I'm not sure whether it's locked or not. So what is happening here, it's a kind of a mental struggle which is happening. What is happening here is that the emotion part is missing here yet. The heart has not yet come into play. So this fight will keep on happening and it will keep you so much unrest, it will bring up so much tension and frustration inside of you that you will just collapse. But somehow what I have seen is, like, unless until you collapse, the heart is not going to come into the picture. Kyunki jo mind hai wo heart ko allow karta hi nahi hai jab tak ki mind collapse na ho jaye. So in a way what I mean to say is, like, the heart is kind of always present. But because the mind is there, it overshadows the heart. तो जो मैं कहना चाह रहा हूँ, जैसे ही heart picture में आ जाएगा, then there will be an acceptance. The moment your mind is going to collapse, there will be acceptance, and that acceptance is saying that it doesn't matter, even if the lock is not there. Fine, of course there will be loss, but what can I do? I'm flying right now. There is no things which are in your hand which you can change right now. Probably when you get down from the airport, you can send a friend to check over. That's the only thing what you can do right now. But this is the time not to fight with yourself. You can't do anything with it at this point. The only point is you just accept it. What heart is going to do here? The heart is going to say that, fine, if the lock is not locked, you don't have to worry. This is what has happened, so it has happened and we can't change it. So let's accept it. And suddenly with that acceptance, the mind and the heart comes into balance. It's a very, very beautiful experience. I'm sure you must have gone through this. But most of the time, we actually not let the mind collapse. And most of the time, the mind continues its rut. It keeps on fighting with itself. And I wish and pray for everyone, you know, like, whenever this rut happens to you, that the mind should collapse and the heart should be able to take care of you. And secondly, what we see is, like, since the sword is a more of a masculine principle, and here a female is shown holding the sword, so she's already has the emotions, she's already, because she's a woman, the emotions are already there. The only problem is it is overshadowed, it is like her eyes are covered. And what does eye stand for? Eye stand for clarity, for seeing things the way they are. Because her eyes are covered, her heart is also covered. If you see that there is this cross like which is there, it is signifying that the heart chakra is blocked. And when your heart chakra is blocked, you are not open for communication. You are not open to communicate further. You are not ready to meet anyone midway. So when the heart opens up, when the cross, the way she is crossing her hands, if she opens up and she takes off her blind, suddenly there is a balance between the mind and the heart. And that is where the completion happens. The problem which this person is going through, that is resolved. This card ka ek aur take hai. This card also stands for truce and cold war. And what it is signifying here is that there is a situation which you don't want to face. And because you don't want to face, you don't want to get into a kind of a discussion or battle. So you have kind of closed your eyes towards that situation. And when you close your eyes towards some kind of situation, you also don't take any action. So again, there are like two aspects to it. One is negative and one is positive. The negative is that there is action which you need to take from your end. Otherwise, this problem will keep on piling up. Because no matter, even if you don't look at it, the problem is still there. You need to get it solved. This is the negative. And the positive, you think there could be also be a positive? Yes, there is also a positive. The positive is, like, for example, you live with someone and you are in love with that person, and there are things, you know, which you don't like about that person, which that person does. But because you love that person, you decide to ignore it. So this is like more on intelligent basis, you know, like this person is coming to a decision not to take any action. Because when we are in a relationship, there are adjustments, there are very few adjustments which we have to make. And the people who are individuals, for them especially, they also have to adjust at least a bit. So this card kind of gives them this kind of a suggestion, like not to indulge into something which is not required. Try not to waste your time and energy into something which you can't change. Just accept it and move forward. Now we go into the little background. What we see is that there is a moon which is like the cycle is finishing, and it is indicating that the moon here is showing lack of clarity, that there is darkness which is rising, and this person is not able to see clearly because of that darkness. So it is also indicating that the moon, since it is ending, it is also a new beginning of the cycle of the moon is about to start. And since it is about to start, this also says that there is a changes which are happening in this current situation, and somehow this person is coming to a point where she will be able to take off the blindfold. A time is coming. Ek waqt aisa aa raha hai, kyunki ye moon change ho raha hai aur moon ki cycle khatam ho rahi hai, aur moon ki ek nayi cycle shuru hone ke sath sath wo hame ye indicate kar raha hai ki इस सिचुएशन में ये जो व्यक्ति है उसका भी टाइम चेंज हो रहा है. फाइनली दैट देयर इज अ सी व्हिच इज शोन एट द बैक. ये बहुत अच्छा सिग्निफाई करता है इस सी, ये जो सी का जो सिंबोलिज्म है वो इस तरह से, सबसे पहली बात तो हमें ये पता है कि ये जो पर्टिकुलर फिगर है जो इसमें शो करिए, जो आप हो या फिर मैं हूँ या कोई भी है, दैट वी आर स्टक इन सम काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन हियर एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू एक्चुअली कम आउट ऑफ इट. And because we are stuck, that there is a problem which is there, and our problem seems to be so big that we are not able to see any further. That's the blindfold which is shown. So see, ये signify करता है कि because you are blindfolded, you are not able to see that there is a vast sea which is behind you. The sea stands for life. The sea stands for its vastness. That it's like so big. It is just signifying that your problems are nothing in front of the sea. अभी तो हम sea को देख रहे हैं, जब हम universe को देखेंगे, जब हम देखेंगे like we are almost like we are like even not even a small dot on this planet Earth, and because our Earth is also like not even a small dot in the whole cosmos, then this problem what we are going through, it will not really make much of the sense. That doesn't mean that you don't go ahead and address your problem. That doesn't mean, you know, you're not going to take care of it. It simply means, you know, like deep inside, you will just drop this thing of, you know, making everything right. The only thing what is going to happen is that there is a kind of a deep understanding which is going to happen inside of you. And this understanding basically tells us that our problems are nothing as compared to this vast universe, this existence in which we live. Let's solve it if we can. If it doesn't solve, don't think too much about it. You just have to say okay. So ultimately this card actually points you towards saying yes. And how does that yes happen? That yes happens when your intellect and when your emotions are connected, when your heart and the mind are in a union, are in a sync. That is when you take the right decision of your life. That is when you start moving in the right direction in your life. Just the intellect or just the heart, they are not enough. They will land you into trouble. They will land you into a situation which is not really good for you. So, just remember, जब भी आपकी reading में two of swords आता है, वो आपको ये indicate कर रहा है कि आपको धीरे-धीरे effort करना है, जिस situation में आप फंसे हुए हैं, उसमें से आपको अपने heart को involve करना है, अपने emotions को involve करना है. You just don't have to think just because from your mind at this point. आपको सिर्फ अपने मन से नहीं सोचना, आपको अपने emotions का सहारा लेना और दोनों को balance करते हुए, way out करते हुए decision लेना. And once you take that decision, the problem which you are in, the fix in which you are in, it will be solved. So this was my reading for you for two of swords. I hope you enjoyed this reading, and I will see you in my next one. Thank you so much for watching. Namaste.